Ciao guys, you're watching Sondros' channel and this is a video tutorial on how to animate in Photoshop. When I was searching for such a tutorial myself, I had encountered a problem that I couldn't actually find any normal tutorial that would show me how I can animate in computer but so that it would resemble that traditional style animation, you know, when you are using a light table, pile of papers, pencils, and so on. So then I discovered that I can do it in Photoshop, and this is what I have learned so far, and I would like to share some of my knowledge with you guys because this is what I would like to find at that moment when I was searching. Unfortunately, I do not have any education on animation or drawing, but still maybe this will be helpful for you to learn or maybe to find something new in animation. So I will create a new document so that we can start from the very beginning. The size is okay and resolution as well. We click OK and we have just a new document, new file. Oh God. So what we have here in the interface? I guess you are already familiar with this menu, and I will not go through all these options, but some very important details to mention. What you need for animation, and this will be a timeline animation, so you will need a timeline. Where to find this timeline? Go to the Windows and try to find timeline. So if you unclick this, it will disappear, and then just bring it back. So, and here we just click on create video timeline. Okay. Now we have a timeline and we have one layer, which is background layer, but for our animation we will need another layer. So let's go layers, video layers. This is what I have never paid attention to, but this one exists, and you click on new blank video layer. Okay. So basically we will be working only on one layer, and how that actually resembles the traditional style animation. For those of you who don't know what it is, you can search for Hayao Miyazaki, how he's creating his films and works when he's drawing the animation, which is very inspiring, at least for me. And so you will see that when someone works, the artist works in traditional style, he has some pile of papers that are fixed on a light table. So let me draw you a light table. Sorry, this is very primitive drawing. So here there is a glass, and there are some lamps. I don't know. Very simple drawing. And the lamps shine through. And when it is your first paper, you have a first paper, and all the other papers are there. You create the first drawing. So this is how it looks for traditional animation, and then you just turn the pages, like the second page, and all the other pages are still there, and you are holding the pages to turn them all the time. So this is what we will be doing here in Photoshop. Just a moment, I need to erase all this bullshit. Why is there no option to clear the layer? Or maybe I don't know, I don't use Photoshop that often. Okay, so let's go. Once again, about timeline. About that pile of paper that we had and what I have mentioned. Here you have it as well, but it is situated a bit differently. Like here, when you move this cursor, you can also change the size of your timeline. And here, when it is zoomed in, each frame is one paper. First page, second page, third page, and so on. So we will be creating our first drawing, and let's make it. Let's say there is a person, the opacity, how you like it, and we have a person. Okay, that's good. In timeline, we are creating our animation with keyframes. What is keyframe? A keyframe is basic movements from which your animation consists of. So here on the first page you have your person, and then you go to the next page, but you cannot see anything. This is what was stupid about Photoshop or any other programs that I have encountered before. And this is very inconvenient when you cannot see what is going on your previous page. You cannot see through where the person was located, how tall he was, and so on. But now you can just go to this. This is like a very small button. Click it and enable onion skins. Onion skills allows you to see what is on your previous page, even though your current page is blank. And you can also go to onion skin settings and change it on how it is more convenient. I don't like to see frames after, frame spacing, whatever that is. And here it will not allow you to put zero, so put it at least one if you do not need a minimum opacity. And here you go. For keyframe animation, you do not draw movement with all these slight, very slight movements. You do not need these details. So what you do at this point, you go on the next page and you create the same person, for example. Maybe it is even possible to copy paste, I don't know yet. And then he raises his hand horizontally. That was the second page. We are going to the third page, and the person is raising his hand. He, I don't know what he's doing, but looks fine. So here we have our very simple, very stupid animation, but that shows you the idea. This is what key animation is about, and this is here I was using a bit more detailed keyframe animation, but still you can see that I do not draw all here when she is raising her hands. I do not draw all the slight movements because, as you know, there are 24 frames in 1 second. 24 gives you the feeling of the smooth movement. Here we do not need this yet. We just need to know the direction of movement, how fast it is, and so on. The same here, for example. I do not need all these smooth movements. I just need to see how she jumps. So let's go back to our person. Let's make him buff. Oh no. Okay. Never mind. And there is also an option that I haven't really went through. This is like frame animation. This is where you work on more details, as I understand right now. And also one small detail that I wanted to mention, why was it so important to me to animate in so that it would resemble traditional style. Here in timeline, it is very convenient that you can scroll it back and forth to see how smooth and how real her or his movements are. So when you are on the border, when your actual animation ends and you need to create another one, it is very, very convenient to create a new animation, a new frame, and a new drawing, because you can see all the previous movements, and you can just imagine how it looks. For example, let's make her move her leg. Let's see how it goes, and let's say it goes like this. I don't know. It's just an example. So the belt goes like this. So that's it. Thank you for watching this video, and I hope that it was really helpful for you, and maybe see you in next videos. Atacho!